Hello, everybody, and welcome back. It's 3 o'clock. That means it's time to play D&D.
Boo! Well, actually, no, not boo. That's fun.
We are still in the process of getting set up. Everybody is leveling up their characters from last week because they all forgot. We're setting up all of the tech stuff on our side. But we should be going probably 10 or 15 minutes. Announcements? None. So real quick before I skip, today is brought to you by, but not sponsored by, Jack in the Box. Tacos are badass, and if Jack in the Box wants to give us money, I can get new equipment.
Why would they sponsor us?
That'd be cool. So yeah, we are not professionals. Please do try this at home. Play Dungeons & Dragons, Pathfinder, your tabletop game of choice with your friends and family, and it should be a good time had by everybody.
Except for the Dungeon Master, because they kill all your monsters.
I warned her going into it that it was going to be like that. So, no thank you. This is my taco.
Oh, God.
Why is my volume on?
Not professionals. We'll be back in a minute.
Thank you. red peas.
What? What?
You prefer purple whole peas? The beans?
What's going on?
You're live.
I'm doing it.
Hi.
I already did the intro like 15 minutes ago.
I'm not ready. I haven't been able to long.
Welcome everyone. We're Xenon Game Labs. We are not professionals. Please play your tabletop game choice at home.
My login information isn't working.
Perish.
Your login information in what?
Roll 20. It won't let me log in.
Great.
I asked if everybody was ready.
Yeah, and you said everyone ready all around? We're live. Wait. Email address? Didn't work.
I said, are you ready? And you said perish, and I assumed that...
That was earlier, before I realized I needed to log into Roll 20, because I forgot.
Okay.
Should I do recap?
No, we're just not actually ready and are going to have to wait a bit longer.
Alright, so, last week we met four new adventurers, Pitch, a tiefling, street kid from Hodo Nolan, Obsidius, a goblin author of travel guides from Hata Healy, Fizzle, a dumpier, fancy man, and Cassandra, a gnome druid.
Cleric.
Okay.
Cleric. And so, all of these people were gathered together. They were each given a note from Dawnbringer Hall that said, you have been chosen for testing. Meet at the arena at dawn.
No further information.
These four brand new candidates for Dawnbringer Hall met at the arena in the morning, and they had to fight Flynn, the battle master of Hodo Nolan, in what was really an unfair and unwinnable fight. However, they did really well, and everybody got to level up from level 1 to level 2 at the end of it.
Yeah, we got wrecked.
Then they basically, everybody just kind of went off to get whatever kind of food they eat. Fizzle went in a different direction than everyone else when he did that. And then everybody went to sleep for the night. And that's kind of where we left it off. Everybody was celebrating their victory in the arena and hanging out and eating some of Luska's food.
It genuinely just isn't letting me log in.
It will not let him log in to Roll 20. So talk amongst yourselves. You guys are around the breakfast table at Hodo Nolan.
It's just not working. Like, I hit forgot password, put in my email, reset password, open it. It's Quora Digest. There's no email.
Just some JSON level of nonsense.
Yes.
When's the last time you restarted your computer?
Not long ago.
JSON with the Patrick certified answer there. When's the last time you restarted? Perhaps you have an update.
I don't. It will tell me. It's just not doing anything.
Jason, do you want to stop the stream while this gets sorted?
Yeah, let's go back to the intro screen for a bit. We'll be back.
It's just straight up not working.
We're still working on it.
It's Tuesday, Jason. I found it.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
Do you think you could get off early?
We finally got it to work. Thank you, Lord. So,
Abby's a roll 20 account decided to commit seppuku.
Yeah.
Seppuku?
Seppuku. It's a Japanese form of suicide. Yes, yes.
I thought you said seppuku. I know what seppuku
is. It finally worked. Okay. It's the morning. Where do y'all go?
I'm at the breakfast table.
Okay. Everyone else?
Morning, breakfast.
I forgot to. There we go.
Yeah, hi, welcome to Xenon. We're all not very bright.
I am the smartest one here.
We're all very cute.
You unmuted yourself. Why would you unmute?
Because I restarted my computer. It left the Zoom call.
Oh, crap. I'm sorry. Did you rejoin?
Yeah.
That's why I'm here.
You rejoined. Wow. See, also, not very bright.
Anyways.
We're all very cute.
Anyways, me and Cassandra so far are at the breakfast table.
Does everyone else just go to breakfast?
If it's breakfast time, Pitch is there, bruh.
So, it looks like this is the way I see it. Of course, I go to breakfast as well. I have no blood, so we go to breakfast, and basically Fizzle and Pitch are, they look like they're in an eating contest. And so... You know, we're just eating, and I mean, two-handed, just getting after it, son.
Just faceful after faceful.
Yeah.
When did the voice actor has left?
I don't know how to do so. Why are we being investigated by a... Was that a sonic screwdriver?
No.
Why... The voice actor went to get his phone.
He did.
So, the voice actor was checking audio levels on streams and making sure everything was working properly.
Boo. Excuse me?
So,
we don't do that here.
What do we think is going to happen today? Does anybody have an idea what we're supposed to be doing?
I believe we were supposed to be informed about our mission today. Our initiation mission, I believe.
Is that what it is?
Training mission.
It's what we were told yesterday after the battle.
Okay.
And that happened today?
I believe so.
That's about right. Sent right off into a mission, zero training, zero preparation. Let's just do it.
Fizzle.
Okay.
Professor said this was a training mission.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Training mission. Meaning this is our form of training.
Okay, guys. I'm gonna have to rein y'all in a bit here. From arguing about the mission. Okay. Beauregard. You're now approached. Okay. You are now approached by Beauregard. What? And he is telling you, and he tells you that. I don't know how to do this for
you. Do a Colonel Sanders impression.
No, God, no. I don't.
See what it is.
Good morning, everybody. I hope that your breakfast is good.
Hi, Professor.
With Madame Luska and her aides cooking, it's always a pleasure.
Well, I didn't get this little pot belly for no reason, let me tell you. So, I'm sure you guys are all itching to know what your mission is, yeah?
Yes, Professor.
Oh, yes, Professor. We do have some questions.
Well, fire away.
Well, first, I'd like to ask, so this is supposed to be a training mission.
That's correct.
But can we die, though?
Oh, absolutely.
That is always a possibility.
I see.
Could trip down the stairs and break a neck. That is death.
I've seen someone die from
a kitten.
No.
Yeah, unfortunately, you're not going to have the protection out in the field that you have in the arena. So, death, dismemberment, damage, all of the D things can happen. Well, maybe not all, but anyway.
Honestly, Professor, that's very scary.
Well, unfortunately, the business that we're in is dangerous.
I just meant with no training. I mean, I'm sure all of these other people have had some fight training, but again, Professor, I feel woefully underprepared.
If it is not too much trouble, to aid Pitch's woes, would it be too much trouble if we went around town maybe shopping for some gear before we head out?
We might be able to help you out with some equipment right here from the hall. As Perfect. Long as your requests aren't too extravagant, we should be able to find you some things down in the vault.
Just enough to make sure Pitch feels okay going into this mission.
Of course, of course.
Honestly, I wouldn't even know what to ask for.
Well,
Mr. Fizzle, you look like a man who's seen the world. What would you suggest?
Well, the only thing that I can really suggest is to make sure that your weapons are nice and sharp, your armor's stout, and prepared for as much as you can. But I always say, travel light.
Understood.
All right. Well, Pitch, I understand that you are concerned, so one second. He disappears into a cloud of purple smoke. A few seconds later, he reappears with some things in his hands for you.
Y'all
me?
Yes, you. You get...
Well, I mean, at this point, you essentially just have the clothes on your back and your spear.
Okay.
Looks awfully like...
That's all I've ever had.
And it looks a lot like one of Madame Francesca's brooms.
You can tell that just by looking?
Yeah, she makes them herself. We have a couple in the back.
Yeah. Great. Don't break.
And so here you go. And he hands you a dagger.
Yep. And y'all get 3 scrolls of minor healing.
Alright.
Scrolls of what?
Minor healing.
Cure light wounds.
Mm-hmm. Same thing.
And these, I believe, should probably go to Cassandra. And so he'll give those healing scrolls to the cleric. To be distributed however you want. Yeah.
How do scrolls work? I've never...
You pick them out, you can take them out of your bag or whatever for one action and then use them. The thing is, any character can use a scroll.
It's like using a spell without using a spell slot or needing magic.
Yeah, and it only takes 2 actions, so you can cast an actual spell also. Or move.
However, scrolls are one-time use items, so if burn after you use them.
Yeah.
Anything else specific anybody would like to request?
Since she only has clothes, could maybe she get armor?
Let me see what I can do. He disappears in a cloud of purple smoke.
Yep, I'm pulling up the equipment right now. That's what I've been doing this entire time.
He stays going a little bit longer this time. You guys get the sense that he's having to rummage through things to find something appropriate.
Just normal leather armor, honestly, is what's...
I actually have some leather armor on me, so I can tell you the stats on that.
Yeah, it's a plus two.
He reappears. Apologies that it took me a minute. I had to find something that would accommodate your tail.
Oh. Oh, that's embarrassing.
It's quite all right.
Well, bitch. As you know, there's not very many of our kind floating around on the material plane these days, so...
Not many at all.
All right, so... I received a letter this morning from the owner of the Spider Bite Brewery and the super posh drinking place down the road, Venom. Now, I don't know if you're all aware, but there is an orchard about 2 days' walk from here.
Can I roll knowledge local, please?
Of course. I don't know, well, Annie.
What are you rolling for?
Just to understand some history about the Spider Bite Brewery, maybe some past incidents that might have been reported, maybe some other information that might be important for our mission.
So basically, rolling to know what the brewery is.
Basically, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Knowledge local. I have a proficiency in that.
Did you put any skill ranks into it?
I did not.
Well, so then it's a pure intelligence.
Knowledge local?
Knowledge local.
Yeah, then it's a pure intelligence
roll. Plus one for me. 17.
Well, you know that the spider bite, that the orchard is overrun with spiders. And that's where the brewery gets its name.
Yes. I believe I've heard some tales of this before I came to town. The Dawnbringers themselves, actually. Second generation. No, just some stories I heard. Maybe some tales of mercenaries going in to help deal with overpopulation. That's all I've heard.
Well, you are correct, Mr. Assidious. The current team of Dawnbringers did have their first mission there, clearing out some spiders, and honestly, we use this mission fairly frequently for new recruits.
Sounds reasonable, I suppose.
I don't like spiders.
I don't either.
Unnecessary parts of the food chain.
Last time I saw one, I had to be pulled from the ceiling.
And so, ladies and gentlemen...
I don't mean to laugh. I'm sorry.
It's quite all right.
That is your mission.
Deal with the
2 days, give or take, to the Rolf Estate Orchards. Thin out the spider population a bit. And come on back with whatever goodies you might find.
Will do. Hopefully we could maybe get some materials or sorts for the hall.
I like the way this man thinks.
I've traveled a bit. I know how some guilds work.
And with that, I'll leave you.
Okay.
His fingers disappears in a cloud of purple.
So, because we're having breakfast...
Can I have some information on armor, please?
Oh, yeah, the armor.
Okay. It's a basic plus two to your AC bonus, yes. Is that correct?
Yes.
Alright.
And... a warning, if you leather. Are wearing leather armor, it has a plus two bonus to your AC, and it has no effect on your movement speed because it is light armor. Although, warning, if you get a maximum dex bonus to your AC of plus six, which you don't have, but that will be important if you go to later levels.
Alright.
You would need to be level 12 for that to matter.
Question for our DM. Because we are having Madame Wolfka's breakfast, are we having
not Hero's Feast.
Understood.
This isn't a party. This is just breakfast.
Got it. Okay.
Can I ask what color my leather armor that I was given was, Professor Beauregard?
Well, oh, hell, what color would you like it to be, dear?
A bright pink.
I absolutely will not. I would think from Beauregard, and it's going to accommodate my tail. It's either black or purple.
Yeah.
If it isn't, I can change that for you.
Dying is...
Beauregard's gone, so you guys can do that.
Dying is a simple process for leather armor.
Oh, I mean, yeah.
I think it would be best if it was black, the same color as her skin.
Mm. I look at it very, very closely, and it becomes, with the precipitation, it becomes black.
That
same
is,
color as her skin.
That's not one of your spell slots for the day, is it?
No, it's a...
No, that's a gnomish spell-like ability.
Okay, cool.
Wait, that's a gnomish spell-like ability?
Oh,
uh-huh.
Okay.
No, gnomes are cool.
That is a useful thing.
All right.
So,
Obsidious,
where do y'all want to go?
I guess I'm going to finish my breakfast, head into...
Well, crap, it only persists an hour.
It's fine.
Oh.
It's a...
My leather's only black for an hour.
Can the DM can DM that.
Shush. Okay. It's not black for an hour. It's just cosmetic. Rule of cool.
Rule of cool.
So, everyone, what I'm thinking we should do is, once we wrap up breakfast, let's go gather our belongings, and do we know in any way where this place is, or...
Oh,
you know,
I might have some help with that because I'm a traveling hero.
Do you
know where it is?
No,
I rolled a 17 for knowledge local.
Yeah,
I know the location.
Yeah, you would know the location.
I'm a townie. I know where it is.
Oh, yeah.
Cool. So what we'll do is we'll just meet at the front gate. You want to say in about an hour?
Very well.
All your stuff, and we can be ready to be on our way. It's a 2-day journey, so we'll need tents.
So what does everyone do?
Obsidious is going to finish up his breakfast. Just kind of visually check up on Pitch real quick. Head into his room, gather his belongings, you know, writing utilities, empty books, journals, whatever he may need to journalize this adventure.
Do you want to write about... Do you want to write about the thing?
About the beginning of our adventure?
Yeah.
I'll start on the beginning.
Yeah. You know what that means.
I gotta roll...
Linguistics. That's what I'm gonna use to make for you writing.
I'm going to... Alright, let's hope this is a good roll. It's a pure intelligence...
God. That one.
No, it's a 3 in total.
Well, God, I'm so...
Why are you making me roll to jot all this crap down?
Because you're writing a journal. You are writing a book. I am making you write to see how well the book is.
And it's pretty funny that the dice are telling the story that they're telling on your book writing.
Yeah.
I'm excited.
From the peanut gallery.
I'm excited. No. It's getting to my head, and it's making me shake, Mill.
No, this isn't like a handwriting. This is the quality of the book.
Oh, God.
Yeah. This is not handwriting. This is quality of the book.
It was a dark and stormy night. Wait.
No. Not
that. Once upon a time.
I'm so sorry.
Obsidious is at the gate trying to figure out how to start the book.
That's fair. Okay. Also, everyone has a tent in their wardrobe as part of standard issue Dawnbringer equipment.
Great.
Everyone just gets one of those.
And I grab one.
So,
tent bed rolling.
Well, yeah.
So one of the things that Fizzle does is he goes to Madame Luska, or I assume Madame Luska, and asks her about a blood supply, just a day or two blood supply, because, you know, food, it's food for me. And
yep.
Is it Luska?
Yes, hello, dearie. What can I do for you?
Indeed, Miss Luska. Did I trouble you for a bit of blood, perhaps? Just for the day's travel?
Of course, of course.
So that I don't have to eat quite so much.
We don't see many of your kind, and so apologies if this is offensive in any way, but, pig? Would pig do? Animal blood of some kind? We stung at?
Go ahead.
There is a... Dawnbringer Hall has no shortage of human blood with the amount of people coming into Big
with.
Yeah, but Luska wouldn't have thought
of that. Oh, yeah. Okay, that's fair.
I do have some leftovers from the sausage this morning.
That would suffice temporarily. Yes, for this short of a run, that would be fine.
Very well.
It will taste awful, but it will suffice for the.
Is there any way I can make purposes. It taste better? Herbs, spices, anything?
Just straight, please.
Very well.
Give me bacon, just a moment. Bacon, not stirred.
She totters off into the kitchen and comes back with with two wineskins. But there's not wine in them. Here you go, Gary.
Ah, marvelous. That'll be plenty. Thank you.
Excellent. You're very welcome anytime. And she totters off.
Right, and with that, Fizzle meanders slowly. He saunters, if you will, to the front door. Pop it. Wait, hold on. My camera's not on.
Did you just realize that? I thought that it wasn't working.
Sorry. So he saunters on, and
Obsidian,
you know,
trying
he's
to figure
giving
out
the finger guns and Obsidian, you know, pointing it, and especially at the ladies, two finger guns.
Obsidian,
Jason, we're watching you log into Roll 20.
Whoops, my bad. Okay.
Obsidian looks up from trying to figure out how to start his book, sees Fizzle being whatever the hell he is, and just goes, "Oh gods." This is the group I'm traveling with.
Awesome. That's the word you're missing.
She's going to finger gun right back at him.
Yeah. He slowly puts his hand on the finger guns and just slowly lowers them.
Oh, I don't have the chance.
Just Pitch is like...
I thought it was a greeting. Is that not how his people do a greeting?
Obsidian, not wanting to embarrass Pitch, is going to whisper an explanation into her ear.
Oh! Ew!
Agreed.
Really?
Trust me.
Okay.
Trust me, Fizzle being this way is going to be very embarrassing.
I'm still kind of flattered.
Ew.
You have to understand, Mr. Possum, not a lot of people talk to me.
I completely understand that, Miss Pitch. However, I would implore you to please not use that as a greeting in the future.
Just do it.
I mean no offense, of course you know this.
Well, I understand.
Just, don't want you to get embarrassed, is all.
So,
all right. So I assume is everyone there, Cassandra?
So far, Pitch.
You with us at the front door yet, or?
So far, Obsidian, Pitch, and Fizzle at the front gate. We don't know about Cassandra yet.
I didn't really have anything to speak of to get, so I've just been sitting there.
Oh. Okay.
Well,
cool.
Is everyone? Everyone going to go?
Small. It's easy to not see me.
Right, so, I say we have at it.
All right.
Gives a little wink. Everybody, let's go.
Yeah.
Okay. I guess we're gonna travel.
Yeah.
So just starts, and he starts walking at a sauntering pace, and then he stops and he says, "I am quite well traveled. However, I've never been in this area. What way do we go?"
I have it. And Assidius.
Way far in the back. Follow the road.
Assidius goes to the front of the group and says, "I know the way. I'm well traveled. Please follow me." And begins leading the group to the
Mr. Goblin fellow, do you think it's wise for someone that uses guns to be in the front?
I'm not following at a distance where I can't be caught off guard and without my team. Do you really think I'm that stupid? I've learned my lesson.
I'm just saying you're a goblin.
And that's I'm all. Saying
I I'm have... not saying you're stupid. I've met many of your kind that are absolutely marvelous and a delight to be around.
From my understanding,
acuity is typically not in the cards.
Let's not get
I'm not saying anything.
Enough.
I love the goblin kind. Okay. I've met some lovely goblin ladies along the way.
Mr. Fizzle, you would allow, I think I'll walk with Mr. Possum in the front. Stick hasn't led me wrong yet.
Excellent. Keep an eye on him. Just make sure he doesn't get dead, please.
Oh, I think he'll be just fine, but I'll be right there if he needs me.
And I'm going to lead my group not at a large distance. I'm going to be at least near them within, 10 feet. And I'm going to lead them to the Spider Bite Brewery.
Well,
I'm going to make sure that I'm a half a step behind because it seems really important to Mr. Possum that he lead.
So it's a 2-day trip. Do you?
I'm just going to walk, I guess.
So,
yeah, there's. As short as I am to keep up, I'm alternating between walking and running.
Well, Fizzle stays, in the back, and he's just sort of sauntering. He's not really going at a fast clip. He wants to sort of keep pace, but he's not particularly worried about it. As long as they stay within fairly close range, then he's not worried about it. He's just sort of sauntering. So he does not mind hanging out in the back with Cassandra.
All right.
The PA is having a moment.
Yes. So during the first night, which I assume we set up camp, is that what we're doing the first night?
Yeah, we keep traveling.
Yeah.
Well, we're gonna keep going for a day's walk, I assume.
Yes. Yeah. What I meant is when we set up camp for the first night.
Of course we're gonna set up camp.
When we set up camp for the first night, there is something I would like to do. I would like to attempt to figure out a way to keep my gun from jamming constantly.
I don't. Get better luck, Scrub.
No, hang on. I'll try knowledge engineering for that one.
Sure.
Let's pray to God. Gods, whatever. I don't know. Your intelligence. 13.
Can't figure it out.
Crap.
You don't hurt your gun. In fact, you understand it a little, how it works a little better, but you can't figure out a way to keep it from jamming.
Yes. Of course.
What's the last time you cleaned it? All that stuff.
I'm surprised you know your stuff about guns, Miss Cassandra, but thank you. I will take that into moderation. And can I use that as the help
action? Not so much gun specific, it is machinery. Can I don't that? Like machinery, but I grew up with it.
All right, I guess I'm going to do that as a help action. Use that as a help action.
No.
Okay, guess not.
I mean, cleaning your gun is a thing. I'm going to treat that like sharpening your weapon would be.
All right. So I guess instead of... And so I guess after I figure out... After I kind of figure out that I can't really figure out how to do it this night, I'm instead just going to take out some gun oil, a rag, and clean my gun.
Yeah, you can do that.
All right. So that gives me what?
The same thing that gave, Pitch, the plus one to attack.
Alright, cool.
Yeah. Sharpening weapons is...
So, when we stop, I'm just gonna look around for, like, rock, since I don't have the back step, of the inn, the morning shade, I'm gonna look around and see if I can find a rock.
We have a bedroll.
This Pitch, might I ask what you're looking for?
Oh, yes, Mr. Fizzle. I'm looking for a rock. You know, normally I sharpen my stick at the back step of the morning shade. But I don't have that. So I'm just looking for a rock.
So that would be roll survival.
So, I mean, is there, let's see, hold on. Okay, no.
Survival?
What am I rolling?
Survival to find a sharp rock.
So if I don't have it, what do I do? I don't have any points in it.
You add just, the mod. You add the
straight modifier.
You add the stat that is next to the that is next to the
pretty
action.
Sure survival is a wisdom. Is wisdom?
I don't have that either. It's an 11.
Okay. Something I'd like to do.
Let her roll.
Yeah,
all right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what does the 11 do then?
You find a rock. It's not like the sharpest rock you've ever seen, but it's a rock, and it will. And all right. I'm sure Luska don't make no bad rooms, so.
No, not Luska, Francesca.
Not Francesca. Francesca don't make no bad brooms, so.
Oh, yeah, no.
These and it's still sharpened from the Coliseum, the arena, because I never used it.
True.
Yeah, actually.
Asidius kind of notices Pitch grab this rock and walks over, starts talking to her.
Okay.
I'm just talking to her, that's it.
Chatting.
Yep. Miss Pitch, do you mind if I ask what you might be doing?
Oh, not at all, Mr. Possum. I'm just, gotta keep the stick sharp. You know, and it helps me to relax a bit. I just, I like to make sure that my I'll be honest with you, Mr. Possum.
Completely.
This stick is literally the only thing that I own in the whole world, and so it brings me great comfort to take good care of it and to know that it is well maintained.
I completely understand. Growing up, I did not have a lot either myself. Me and my family. We grew up in poverty, me and my little sister. But after...
You have a sister?
Yes, a little sister in Hada Healy. She's truly an angel. I send letters as much as I can.
It's wonderful.
After I started writing my travel guides and other psychology books, I started being the breadwinner of our family, or the gold harvester, if you will. My family are, I'd say, upper middle class at this point. They're still receiving as much gold as I possibly can send them without going into personal poverty myself.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I understand that.
However, now that I'm going... However, if this mission is successful, I'll have a second source of income for them, and I may not have to worry about that.
I'm sure Professor Beauregard would be able to help you in any way. Such a nice man.
He is, but... See, I don't think that would be fulfilling enough for me.
I understand that, yeah.
I feel like that if... My travel guides and psychology books, I worked on them. I worked on them. They're products of my heart and blood, sweat, and tears. Yeah, I feel that if I'm going to start making gold, I need to do it the hard way. It's the only way I've ever known, really.
Understand that completely. Absolutely.
And take it from
some... I'm going to kind of glance over and see what Cassandra is doing.
Looking around at the various plants in the area.
Well, are you looking for something in particular?
Trying to see if I recognize anything.
World perception.
Survival. Yeah, that too. I'm sorry, I just personal experience.
Perception is
that, what am I rolling?
Survival.
I just
mm-hmm. Okay.
She has all the points, I bet.
No.
No one ever, because no one ever
that's
makes
a five on the pill.
Oh no. You add your wisdom, so that's a 10, right? Or is it a
9?
Okay.
It's grass.
You see
it's green.
You see that you're coming up on a forest. And there's a couple of fruit trees that must have spread from the orchard. Not too many though.
Honestly, it's mostly looking around and more to the point, sniffing around. Smelling all of the different. Yeah.
Man, Anulo people are weird.
Just you, man.
So, her profession before she escaped from Daeed was perfumer.
That's right, right. Smells would be her thing.
Yeah. Well.
And so surreptitiously, when she finds something that has a pleasant smell, that is that is not like Aid, will gather it with the intent to extract the oil later.
Well, with the 9, you don't find anything particularly good. And there is the general pleasant plant nature smells, but other than that, it's nothing particularly good. There's no one distinct smell that you can make out.
Just annoyed muttering. That's about it.
I have to say, I travel with a weird group.
Izzel, how about you?
So, I just want to glance around for a big, for a largish rock or
camera,
tree or
camera.
I think my USB port may be unstable.
Insulation.
I'm gonna have to, here in a minute, I'm gonna disconnect and find a different USB port for my camera. I just want to look around for something somewhat large so I can just cast light on it, so we can have light during the night. Not for me, but to keep things away and like animals away, etc. And for the others that don't have it, low light vision, all that.
Doesn't everyone in the party have low light vision?
No, let's see. We got a tiefling, goblin, dampier, and gnome.
I think that's
everyone. Some have low light.
Huh?
Okay. Well, it's not necessary. So if it's not necessary, then I won't bother with it. It's
but
not
you won't know that it's not necessary.
Oh, true.
Yeah.
So then I look around and I just cast light on whatever the large object. I mean, it doesn't matter if there's like a pine cone or something that's...
Pine cone, rock, tree, whatever.
Something that's hanging from a tree or a rock that's sticking up, something like that. And yeah. Cast light on it. That's all. I set up my tent and I tell everyone that I will be retreating to my quarters for dinner this evening. And should we set up a watch, or should we just trust that we're safe?
Well, we can take turns.
Okay. Who would like the first turn? I don't mind. I'm open to anything.
I'll take it. I am the one with the gun, after all. It'll wake everyone up if something happens.
True.
Oh. Also, before we move on from my turn, I'd like to put some more bullets back into my gun so it's got a full chamber.
I just assumed you did that after combat.
Ah, yeah, true.
Okay. I just assume you do that after every combat.
Yeah, so I got a full chamber. I check my chamber, know it's full, and basically, yeah. If there is a monster, I'll fire off a warning shot that'll wake everyone up.
Just shoot the guy.
That too.
Okay. So you're looking for something to light up, Fizzle? Just to make it easy.
Nothing.
Like massive.
Nothing necessarily crazy. I'm not looking for anything specific. Just
something to make light.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'd say roll survival. You're in nature.
Okay. Let's see. Da, 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 da. Where are my skills? Oh, never mind.
Check your phone.
And
okay, you find a tree nearby that you can cast light on. Or pine cone, or whatever.
That's fine. I just cast light on it, not a big deal.
Okay, now it's lit up.
And retreat, and I tell everyone that I'll take the last shift.
Alright.
Everyone ready?
Yeah, I guess we'll start our shift rotation.
I'm fine. I can relieve you, Mr. Possum, when you get tired.
Alright. I'll take first watch. Pitch will take second. Sandro, you want to go third?
Probably.
Alright. Now, Assidious is going to assume a post, making sure there's no dirt or grime or anything on his gun, just kind of going over it with a rag.
Yeah.
And he's going to let everyone retreat to bed.
Yeah, I'll make it through the night just fine.
Alright.
The cat doesn't bother setting up a tent. She just rolls up in the bedroll.
Yeah, there's no way Pitch is going to make a tent. She's not pitching a tent.
Okay.
No. No tent.
Okay.
Alright. Second day, here we go.
Okay.
Y'all wake up, nothing happened during the night. Everything went well.
Yeah, I started with that. Sorry.
Yeah, it's fine. I'm assuming y'all are traveling the rest of the way to the Wolf Estate?
Yep.
Presumably.
Okay. Ah, crap, I need to pull up the box. Left when I restarted my computer.
We're going... Yeah. During our walk to the Rolf Estate, I'm gonna... kind of keep walking. I'm going to start walking backwards at a slow pace, and I'm going to start talking to the rest of the party. Once we get there, do you think we should talk to the tenants of the estate, or should we just start killing spiders?
But, I mean, I have found that the people in the kitchen generally know what's going on. We could check with them.
I
would say depends on which we encounter first. Lasers or is they proper?
That's true.
I would say that's appropriate, Miss Cassandra.
So, just to make sure, I need clarification. What is our exact mission? Just to... murder spiders?
From what I remember...
The third word is cold.
From my remembrance of that 17 I rolled...
Uh-huh.
The stories I've heard is that the Rolf Estate has hired Dawnbringer Hall multiple times to whittle down, but not exactly exterminate, the dun spider population.
Well... if we go and we just start killing them.
Yeah, I mean, that sounds terrible.
Well, I mean, you know, we have no idea how many we should take out.
No
idea. So I say we go talk to the folks at the estate. Unless we come across spiders, then, of course, you know, if we come across the spiders on the way there, then we, of course, you know, murder them to shit. But... you know, first let's talk to the people if we can.
For once, you've had a thought behind all that glitz and glamour, Fizzle.
Well, Mr. Goblin, I'm a realist. And I know that I'm beautiful, and I try not to let that influence my thoughts. But...
I didn't say you were beautiful, Mr. Fizzle. I don't know who in this party has said that, but...
You don't have to say it. I'm well aware.
She's just soaking it all in. She has no idea if this is normal or not. She's just like, really? Okay.
No. Pitch, no. Don't take them as an incident. Don't. These are bad examples, Pitch. Don't do it. Okay.
All right, come on, friends. Little gnome. Let's make our way. What you say?
Okay.
Didn't mean to rhyme, but...
Oh, I love rhyming. It's fantastic. Should I sing us a song?
Oh, God.
Oh, Miss Pitch, you should definitely sing us a song as we're walking. That would make the time go by much faster, I believe. Or slower, but we don't know until it happens.
I'm inclined to agree.
You should absolutely think.
Yes, by all means, Miss Pitch, please.
Roll performance. Unless.
She has proficiency.
Roll performance unless you have a song prepared.
Oh.
Well, I have a song.
Okay, let's hear it.
Hey, are we ready? Now, I'm having a little trouble deciding. Should we sing like a traveling song? Or do you think you would be more inspired by, do we need like an inspirational? But, you know, I've been studying the Celine Dion.
Are you speaking of songs of inspiration?
Yes. Do you know it?
I have encountered many a bard in my travels, actually, so I know how they work. By all means, if you believe you can sing a song of inspiration, that would be greatly appreciated.
Feel free to inspire us, little one.
I don't actually know the tune for some of these.
Even better.
Kind of appropriate.
Right?
Ash, money taken.
Just, she just starts going, police comes.
Okay, here we go. Okay, this is gonna be real loud. You might want to turn. You might want to turn that down a little bit.
I'm gonna blow out this candle.
Oh, ready? Okay. And she starts pounding the bottom of her broom stick kind of into the pathway to make her a beat. Not the pointy part, obviously, but the bottom of the broom.
The butt inch.
The butt. Yeah. Hey, let's go. The phone in a straight butt. The phone in a straight butt.
That is absolutely.
Are we at the roll?
100% original. I love that. You sang that to the best of your abilities.
Yes, truly, Miss Pitch, a performance of a lifetime. Are we at the roll estate?
Pat the back of her cap. That was very entertaining.
Okay.
If it's possible for a pitch black cheek to blush, she's doing it.
I don't know. What color blood do tieflings have?
Oh, I'm sure you'll find out soon enough.
Yes.
Oh, God.
Purple.
Ouch.
Rude.
Well, you roll with advantage for the performance, because that was amazing.
Not only was the song amazing, but breaking the DM was also entertaining for me.
Thank you. I aim to please. That was a 15.
Yeah.
With advantage.
With advantage.
Say maybe it just puts a pep in everybody's step, yeah. And they get there a little
quicker. Move a little faster, maybe.
Yeah.
Trying to get away from me and my screaming.
That silence was deafening.
I start humming the tune. She's saying.
Unironically catchy.
But, you know, in proper time, I would assume.
Nope, exactly as I heard it.
Nice.
Okay. We're coming up.
Oh, moving.
Yeah, we've been moving. This has been a moving thing. I was backwards walking.
Yeah.
When I was talking to the bird.
Has the thing been rolled?
The what? She rolled a 15.
Okay.
Yeah.
Which made us move
you make
a little
it,
faster.
You make it there in like half the time.
Great. So now we're at the Rolf Estate, I guess?
Yep.
Cool.
As you get to the Rolf Estate, I want y'all to roll perception.
Oh, gods.
To natural 20.
Okay.
I got 12.
Okay.
I got a nat 1.
Oh, Sandra.
You have somehow.
And this is the same die that treats Sylviana so stinking well.
You find a particularly beautiful smelling plant.
No.
Stop DMing, Matt.
I'm joking. I'm only making a joke. It's up to DM.
I know.
Okay.
Why do you keep doing it then?
Because it's fine.
It's really not.
Yes, it is. I say it is, so it is.
Alright, well, we'll stop. Now let's move on, yeah.
Yes.
Fizzle, what did you roll on perception?
Put in the roll 20 chat, I rolled a 15.
Okay. Yay!
Everyone except for Sylviana, who apparently got some dirt in her eye.
Sylviana's not here.
Sorry, not Sylviana.
Cassandra.
Cassandra. I heard Sylviana's name, and then I just...
Dawnbringer brain went brr.
Yeah. Everyone except for Cassandra, who got some dirt in their eye, and her eye, sees that the Rolf Estate is massively overgrown, and it looks like there hasn't been anyone there in years. Not years. Well, yeah, years.
Mr. Fizzle, can we get a light spell going real quick?
It's like midday.
Sure. And I just snap my fingers. Poof, there's the sun.
Thank God. Okay. I'm going to cautiously pick up a pebble, and I'm going to throw it in front of our group.
Nothing happens. You aren't in the estate yet.
Okay.
Y'all are just in front of it.
Okay. And I'm going to turn to the rest of the group. Let's try to take this cautiously. This place looks semi-abandoned.
I've squatted in many abandoned homes, and this one seems quite abandoned.
That's why
just I asked. From the outside. So I agree. Let's approach cautiously. Miss Pitch, would you mind seeing if you can kind of make yourself go poof? Keep an eye on us from the shadows, perhaps.
So stealth.
What'd you roll?
To 22.
Jesus.
Okay.
He just disappears.
Okay.
22.
Everyone should have control of their characters. You should
also. Point of order, not in character. Did you tell the DM what rogue power you took?
No.
This might be a good time to.
I took stealth.
Okay.
So that means that's I can fair. Move at regular speed when I'm stealth.
Yeah, that's one of the best rogue abilities. That's.
Okay, so I will, hold on, let me look at something, one moment.
We're not looking at you.
Oh, shit. Pardon me. Sorry. Okay, I'm plugged in. There we go. All right. There we go. A moment, cast mage armor, and it's a +4 bonus. And so that lasts for like hours.
Yeah, I'm checking how long that it's going to
be. 1 hour per level, so 2 hours for me.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. So I'll take the front, and what I would like is I would like Cassandra to be in the middle, and then Mr. Goblin, I'd like for you to be in the back, just to make sure that we keep Miss Cassandra safe, okay?
Very well.
Okay. And so, well, you're the healer, young lass, and you know, we have to make sure that you're safe so that we don't die too. Because if you die, we die. Mm-hmm. So, all right, now that I'm mage armored up, I pull out my sling, and I cock a rock, and start walking.
You have a sling?
Yeah, I have a sap and a sling.
Okay.
Okay, I've put my token behind Cassandra, just in case.
Yeah, I don't know if I can move mine. Yeah, oh yeah, I can.
You should.
Apologies again. The grid doesn't exactly match up. I've been struggling with that in roll 20. So.
So Miss Pitch, I would assume you would be off the side, but.
Somebody's touching my. Don't touch
my
stuff.
There was somebody on top of somebody else, and I was trying to figure out who it was.
Stop touching her stuff.
Don't touch you, llama.
I'm sorry.
Well, you can come find me. Sorry.
Yeah. Okay.
So I guess we start slowly approaching. Not exactly at a steady walk, but you know, maybe 3/4 speed or so. Not trying to make too much noise, but not really.
Could we do like a group stealth?
We're on a path.
Yeah, y'all.
Well, I mean, we could try to each individually do stealth rolls. I don't know how well that's going to fly, but considering that I have a...
I'm going to just say no real quick. Okay. I'm going to say no to that just because y'all need to roll initiative.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
What did we say no to?
Group stealth?
Because y'all are rolling initiative.
Hey,
Pitch is stealth, by the way.
Mm-hmm. Whatever adds
to initiative. 4. Okay. You got to get used to this sheet.
Okay. Yeah, this.
Can you see me when I roll?
Yeah.
Can you see me rolling?
I saw your roll, though. Because we may need to compare dex modifiers, because I rolled a 14 too.
I have a 0, so whatever.
I have a 4.
Okay.
Yeah, I go before you.
All right, everybody, I guess. There you go. Let's put your roll in the roll 20 chat.
Okay.
That would be the easiest way to go about it.
12, 14, 7.
Abby, you don't have to put yours in.
Oh, I do, because just ordering the things.
But you can put the order in the...
So I am going to. So...
Very good.
I assume...
Very good.
Opossum has a higher dex than Fizzle.
I put it in the chat. I have a dex modifier
indeed.
+4, so I go before him.
Okay. Thank
we
you.
Talked about it beforehand.
So
that's a 14 from me, then Fizzle.
1, Opossum. 2, 1, Opossum. 3, Fizzle.
Okay.
3,
is monsters. Four is Pitch. Wait, no, four is Cassandra.
Then we have Pitch.
Hey, you didn't get the Curse of the Cleric initiative.
So I know you're doing it in roll 20, but it is also on the board. So what I am looking at here, and you guys let me know if I have the correct
one to attack.
So I have Assidius coming in at first with a 14, with a plus 4 to dex. I have Fizzle second, also with a 14. Then we have our enemies. Then I have Cassandra with, what did you end up rolling on initiative, Cassandra?
10.
10. And then Pitch bringing up the rear with what?
7.
Pitch?
7.
7. Okay.
Hey, by the way, where are the where?
Well,
I know where the they should be.
Mm-hmm.
Like in the thing, but then like spawn them in.
I'm doing so now.
Can you spawn them in as like a GM thing? For now.
That's not the right one.
No, that is not.
Oh my god!
That is not the right one. Okay.
I haven't resized them down.
They're not that big. I mean, whoa, hey, that's.
I don't know why it's doing that. That's weird.
Okay.
I'm resizing them and then. Uh-oh.
Hey, look! There's another one.
Discover check.
Oh god. Hey, I can't select them.
I'm working on that.
Hey, I can't select them.
You're bothering me.
Okay.
It takes me a second, okay?
What? No.
I have to do all this stuff on the fly because I'm not smart enough to do it not on the fly.
Who needs to actually prepare for combat?
Okay, you should have control of them. You can put them wherever you would like. My face is still on the screen. Bye.
I can't.
You can't move them?
I can't even select them. I'm on select / move. I need to reload the page. I'm reloading the page. There we go.
You can move them now?
Yeah.
Cool. Cool and the gang.
Excellent. There we go.
I kind of know what I'm doing. Kind of.
Yep. Okay. By the way. Oh, we are going to take our break now,
because
It seems,
look,
it's right before combat.
This is what we do. Everybody rolls initiative, you throw a bunch of monsters on the screen, and you're like, okay, we're on break. And it gives everybody a second.
Yeah.
So, how long do you guys think you need?
Not long.
5 minutes. No.
I mean, 5-10 minutes, maybe.
Okay. We'll be back in 5 to 10 minutes then, and.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back. We are currently doing combat.
Great. So, yeah, fun.
So, as you are walking down the path, someone, and you notice, there's quite a lot of webs around here, and it doesn't seem like the last few people who came to pull the population did too well.
I don't like this.
And then someone steps on a web that was on the path.
Wait. Oh god.
And then, and so we've already rolled initiative. So, three spider swarms drop out of the trees. And combat is a go.
Okay.
Nah, combat's a go.
I'm not food.
Okay. Immediately after seeing the swarms drop, I'm going to take a pot shot at the one over here.
Can I be heard?
Yes.
Okay, good. Just, it didn't sound right. So, sorry.
Okay.
Something 15 feet.
Yeah.
So, because... I'm going to take my first shot, because I pulled my gun out after I noticed that this place was kind of sus.
That's fine.
Well, that's a 19 on the die.
Yeah.
So, successfully cleaning my gun has worked, and I take a pot shot.
So that's a dirty 20. By the way.
No, but my base attack bonus is plus... because I polished my gun.
Well, the polishing your gun doesn't increase your base.
I cleaned it,
doing stuff to your... Okay, that's...
You said it would be like sharpening my weapon.
Yeah, that doesn't increase your base attack bonus. It increases the bonus for that weapon. Okay. It's a small difference, but...
Is it plus one to attack for him?
Not anymore.
Oh, okay, it was.
Yeah.
No,
so sharpening your weapon only matters for one hit.
It would have been a 23 in total.
Yeah, that hits.
Okay, so I'm rolling a 1d4.
Plus your dex bonus.
Plus my dex bonus. Where are my keys? That's the question. 4d4. D4 and my dex bonus. Ooh, that is an 8 in total.
Maximum damage.
Woo! How many spiders do I take out? With just that one shot.
That is...
Like, how many spiders are in each swarm, and how many do I take out?
I ain't telling you that. You take out 7 spiders.
Great. So... Assidious notices that there's this swarm all of a sudden to his... Okay, so we're going this way, right?
Yes, y'all are going down the path.
So he sees a spider swarm to his right and is immediately like, oh, hells nah. Aimed his gun. The rest of the team hears a gunshot. You hear the screech of several spiders dying.
From the impact of the shot.
And they explode into good.
And that was my first action.
Mm-hmm. We have 2 more.
I knew. Okay. Now, I'm going to try to take another shot at that same swarm. I know there's a minus 5 penalty.
Yes.
Ooh, that is... Yeah. 5.
That does not hit.
I figured. Second shot goes off. Misses.
You just
hear the impact of like a bullet going into the ground. you hear the sound of a gun. They hear the sound of a gun going off, but they don't hear the impact.
Yeah.
All right. Got and
one last shot.
Now, instead of attacking, I'm going to hold my last action as a dodge action.
Okay, so what exactly does that mean?
It means that if any of these spider swarms attack me, I'm going to dodge their attack.
He's holding his move action so he can bail if anything starts coming at him.
That makes sense. Okay, it Fizzle's turn, and the monsters are on deck.
All right, so do I know that the monsters are there? Am I seeing...
They
have made themselves revealed to us?
Yes.
Yeah, and you did hear my gun go off twice.
I recognize that, but I'm asking about the other squads of guys.
They are visible. They are visible.
They're not hiding in any way.
No.
Not from my understanding.
Okay. Okay, so... I've got my sling out. And... Oh, alright. So, first time, I'm going to use my sling, and I'm going to... Boom! And fling a rocket at some sons of guns.
Which ones?
These.
I'm sorry, I missed it. What?
The these.
Okay.
The one's already damaged.
18.
What was that?
18.
You hit.
Alright, and... Hang on. Trying to get to my weapons again. There we go. All right. Four damage.
How much?
Four. Zoom tight.
Is that in total, or did you add your dex modifier?
That's...
Oh, right, you have a plus zero dex bonus. That's total.
Okay. You kill.
So that's my one. Then I'm going to... cast a spell. I'm going to drop my sling.
Drop.
And I'm going to cast a spell. And... That spell is called Summon Weapon.
Uh-oh.
Okay. Let me do the thing real quick. You never gave me the thing.
List?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm just going to tell you the number.
I'm
just going to tell you
the number. Okay, you tell me what it is.
3.
Right, and so... Fizzle stands up very tall and goes, "Worry not." And then he casts a spell, raising his hand above his head like he's reaching for something. And he says, "Me and my trusty crossbow will take these out." And all of a sudden in his hand appears a spear. And he just looks ashamed and defeated. And so he just says, I meant my spear. Me and my trusty spear will help take care of these guys. And so he flings his spear at the guys.
As soon as it leaves your hand, it disappears.
So he says, "Sorry, I'm still working on that one." And
it's, I'm thinking together they'd be useless.
So then he pulls out his
is having a moment.
He saps as a quick spider. Draw, and he's done.
Awkward.
Oh, sap. Third action.
No, throwing the spear was the third action. Summon weapon was a separate action, and then throwing the spear was the third.
Fan flippin' tastic.
Monsters are up.
Also, Asidius' goblin accent came out for a second there.
Oh, I need to do a thing, don't I?
Hmm? What thing?
Okay.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Okay. We'll see how this goes.
Okay.
So the monster is going to run up to Asidius.
Oh god.
You shot him.
Yeah. Twice. Well, shot him
once.
Yeah.
Once.
And didn't you hold a action?
I held an action to basically be like, you gonna attack me?
Nope.
So you have a move action, you can use your full move speed to go wherever.
Yeah.
I am going over... Yeah.
I'm gonna say that happens as soon while
it's running over.
Yeah, so no attack of opportunity. So instead, since...
Oh god!
This guy just lost his meal, he's going to attack the cleric.
My bad.
So, and that's an 18 on the die.
You're muted.
And I'm hit. Thank you.
Okay. So, oh, wait. Sorry, never mind. You take one damage and make a reflex save.
On my character sheet just forked.
We can.
We have got to get.
Steve. Hmm? I'm sorry, what was that?
Steve for the reflex save.
16?
16 on the die.
You make the reflex save.
Phew!
Okay. So now we have the rest of the spiders. This one is gonna go here.
Oh god!
And it is also going to make an attack roll. What is it? Do they have a bonus on the thing?
I don't know, is it on the sheet?
I don't see it, but that could just be me being blind.
No.
Okay. That is a 9. What is alt boat? Does that hit on the cleric or fizzle?
Say again.
Does that hit on either on fizzle or Cassandra?
What was the roll?
9.
No.
Trying to figure that out.
Well, you're looking at your AC.
Yeah.
It hits?
You have a 9.
No. Sorry.
Because you would have to have a negative dex bonus for that to hit, and no armor.
No. That's 14. I just hadn't built that in.
Okay.
What about our wizard?
That doesn't matter. It wouldn't have been.
Okay.
Let's see. Try this. Okay, so this little guy is going to move here. And now it is Cassandra with Pitch on Deck.
That voice cracked though.
Yes, that did happen.
Going to swing at...
Which one?
What, the higher up one.
Okay, the one to the left of you.
For left. And that was a 15 to hit.
What was it?
3.
13?
That hits.
Cool, you hit.
Points of damage.
How many?
4.
Okay. That the last spider there has died. There was one. That one is going to be dead.
Click it and hit your delete key.
Thank you.
Cool. Killed it.
Hooray!
On the back swing, I'm going to attack the one beside me.
Okay. Roll to hit.
That's a minus 5?
Yes.
So...
16.
Was a dirty 20 minus 5 is 15.
Okay.
That hits. Demons?
Wait for damage.
So your audio is like...
Flipping.
It's
hard.
Flipping, and so we're not hearing the very beginning of what you're saying, so we're missing all of the numbers.
That sucks.
Yeah.
Three points of damage.
Okay. Thank you. That's the one. There we go.
Yay, we got a swarm.
Wait, what type of damage was that?
Bludgeoning, probably.
She's using a mace.
That's bludgeoning. Okay.
Yes.
Just making sure.
Say again.
Swishing with the
ear.
Swishing with the mace.
Okay.
So slashing damage.
Swish. It's bludgeoning.
Okay. What is your last action?
Kind of hold for getting out of the way. They decide to go after me again, or if somebody gets hurt, I will heal.
Okay.
When you hold an action, you have to do one or the other. It's either going to be the move action or a heal. You can't.
I always forget that in Savage Worlds. It's just you're holding an action.
Right. Unfortunately, the way we do it is you have to call whatever action you are holding. Like you're preparing to do a thing, not two things.
Okay. In that case, never mind. I will just up here.
Okay.
I'm not leaving engagement, so no attacks of opportunity.
Okay. Now that we've got Matt out of the way, who's next?
Pitch, it is your turn with Osidius on deck.
Great.
Right, so I am hiding here, so I'm going to sneak attack.
Oh,
swarm right here.
Does she also get a backstab bonus?
That's flanking.
It's flanking. So
flanking backstab bonus. Flanking sneak attack.
She's also stealth, so she would get it anyway.
She'd get it anyway.
Somebody just tell me what to roll and what to add.
Let me pull up.
It's an 18 on the dice.
That hits. Rogue at level 2 does sneak attack plus 1d6.
D6 at first level. So you do, you roll, you hit, you roll your damage, and then you roll an extra 1d6 for your damage.
Okay. And so I'm rolling 2d6.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Huh. So those bars above your token, you can have them as like anything.
Mm-hmm. You consider it stealth, of course she's not stealth anymore.
So when I roll damage, it is a straight what's on the dice?
So when you roll damage, you do you have weapon finesse? Well,
it's going to be plus strength for damage.
Plus strength, yeah. And
so
to attack.
Okay, so that...
Because spear is two.
Roll a 6, a dice. A strength this month is 1, so that's 7.
And that was 2d6?
2d6. So I got 7. A total of 6.
So 7, adding your strength.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Cat is unhappy.
Yeah, he's mad. He's big mad.
So, how much damage is that?
7.
How much of that was, how much was sneak attack?
I don't know.
That matters.
What were the 2 die rolls?
4 and a 2.
So the sneak attack would have been the 2.
Okay. Yeah, these monsters need to be changed.
Okay, let me talk about that.
Yeah, we'll do it later.
Why is nobody on camera right now?
Mostly because I have an ice pack on my jaw for wisdom teeth.
Oh.
I was shoving Tisha in my face.
Got it.
I'm not here.
I'm here. I'm always here. I'm just kind of... I'm not doing anything special. Okay, Osidius, it is your turn.
Great. I am going to... I am immediately going to take a pot shot at,
Wait, this... was that all 3?
No, it wasn't. Not at all. You still have 2 actions.
Oh, never mind then.
Sorry.
Stab it some more.
Okay. I don't get sneak attack anymore, right? So I just get the 1d6 plus my strength.
Yes.
It's the bonus.
Yes.
It's 4.
Four what? Okay, that does not hit.
Oh, wait. I'm rolling to hit. That was not... I didn't roll the right thing. Hold on. 14.
That hits. Wait, did you do the minus 5 because it's your second attack?
It's with the minus 5, yeah.
Okay. Just making sure. That does.
Then I roll. That's a 5 on the die, so that's 6 damage.
Okay. You get one more action.
Okay, I'm gonna hit it again. I got nothing else.
Okay. Roll with a minus 10.
Wait, time out.
What?
Okay, so on my third shot, instead of hitting, I'm going to sneak back into the shadows.
That
free stealth.
No.
Why not?
They have direct line of sight of you.
Oh.
There is
direct. They don't. There's a tree. There's a literal tree.
That spider swarm is literally right next to you, and there is another one right beside it.
It was worth a shot.
If you were to move, risking an attack of opportunity, you could move around the tree to get cover, then do it.
That would take 2 actions, and I've already spent 2 actions.
Yeah, you get a free 5-foot step, and then take your movement. So you could 5-foot away to disengage, and then then make a move around the tree to regain stealth.
Okay, well then that's what I do.
That would still be 2 actions.
Oh, it wouldn't.
No, it's not. 5-foot step is a free action,
but then moving around the tree would be enough.
Would be the third action.
Yeah.
Which means I wouldn't be able to stealth, but I could get behind the tree.
Yes. But you would take an
attack. Well, I'm going to move around behind the tree then.
Because you're moving out of melee.
No, the 5-foot step doesn't.
Oh, she disengaged first? Okay.
No, 5-foot step doesn't take attack of opportunity.
Oh. Alright then, you're clear.
I had a discussion with this with my dad.
Okay. Hey, Panda.
Okay. So it is now Fizzle's turn with the monsters on deck. Well, no, it's Osidius's turn with Fizzle on deck. Keep Perfect. Skipping people. Sorry.
Okay, pot shot at the monster, here.
Okay.
I'm gonna hero coin that. I gotta re-roll that.
Your hero coins.
That was the sound of a hero coin hitting the table. And then the flip.
Do I still add my clean bonus?
No, that was only your first attack.
Okay, so then in total, that is 14.
That hits.
Cool. Then I roll a 1d4, add my dex bonus. That's a 5.
Yeah, it's dead.
I killed it?
Yeah, it had 1 HP.
Cool.
Yeah. You brought something down to 1 HP and then killed something. These things are dying quick.
So, I'm gonna turn to this spider. For my free action, I yell duck! And I'm gonna shoot it.
You had precision shot. You can shoot things into melee range.
That's flavor text. Yeah.
Flavor text.
All right. Now we're gonna roll to attack. I know minus 5. That's a dirty 1.
Dirty 1.
Yeah.
almost hitting. Almost.
Shut up. Okay. For my final action, instead of attacking, I'm going to hold my final action. If the swarm tries to attack any of my allies, I'm going to shoot at it.
Okay.
Fizzle, you're up.
Yep, with the monsters on deck.
Alright. So, where am I? Oh, okay. I will... here. Take a 5-foot step. Well, it's supposed to be from this corner to this corner so that I can get this guy here. Sure. But,
right there.
And I've got quick draw as my feet, so I pull my sap.
Yeah.
And thwack. And I'm going to roll 1d20.
Sap does more than any.
Yeah.
15. Does that hit?
Yes. How much damage?
And my damage will be... d6.
Wait, your sap does 1d6? Wow.
Damage. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to do that again. Rolled a 2. That does not hit, I assume?
No.
Then,
one more time.
Oh, miss.
Does not hit.
We're going to celebrate. Alright.
So I'm done.
Okay.
Okay.
The monster, since you have killed, since it just watched all of its friends, brethren, die, it is screaming for help. And we are getting a few new friends on the edge of the map. Not that big. They are not.
I'm doing it live.
That's just me. Sorry, it just caught me off guard again.
You know what? I'm going to do it in a different way. Hold on, guys.
Oh, no. Just going to, Control-C.
I thought there was a way I could duplicate them.
Yeah, you select it. Control-C, Control-V. Ta-da.
Yeah, there you go. So you can add them.
Yeah.
All right, so put them where they need to be coming in from. The gunshots ringing out through the forest probably tipped them off.
Yeah.
That there was something tasty this way.
So we got a couple more. And this one, with two actions remaining, is going to attack.
The call for help was an action?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm going to treat it that way.
That's fair.
Does an 11 hit on either of you?
Is it some sort of splash deal?
Yes.
Okay, no, it does not.
I'm willing to say this is splash damage. This is not.
Actually.
Shut up!
Because it is a swarm, there's a bunch of little ones and they can attack anything that's in their range. Like, a couple of them will attack one, and a couple of them will attack the other. It's the way the swarm works.
Anything within melee range.
Exactly.
Karen, does an 11 hit? I don't think so, but... Huh? Okay. By the way, Basidius, I just attacked. Use your held action.
Oh, yes, because...
Yeah.
Because the swarm is trying to hit my allies, that immediately means there's going to be a pot shot at them.
Mm-hmm.
So. That's a nat 20. Woo! F your monster.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm just going to roll 2d4.
That should not be how much health that has.
Double your dice.
Doubling my dice, yeah.
Double the damage.
Hang on, I gotta find the second one.
Woo! D4!
Just roll it and double it.
Help that too.
That's how we normally do it. You just roll one die, but you double the number on the die.
Okay. We're gonna roll our first one. Let's see. 4, 9. Did I just kill a monster?
Nope. Not quite.
Jesus, how much is it at?
Not much. There is one spider left.
Oh. Hey, Cassandra. You ever wanted to squish a spider with your boot?
Through these spiders?
There is one left to the swarm next to you.
Right, but how big are they? Because she's little.
I am wee.
They're about...
yay size.
The entirety of my foot.
It's the size of a wolf spider.
This particular variety of dun spider is somewhere between 3 and 5 inches in diameter.
It's about the size of a wolf spider.
Sorry about that.
Okay. I'm going to use my last action to attack again.
You're rolling that one.
No, I rolled a 12.
Mm.
Does that hit? I'm gonna guess the answer is no.
Cassandra is shaking. It would be correct. Fizzle, 12 hit?
No, it does not hit, but no stretch of the imagination.
Yes.
Although, if there's only one spider left in that group, wouldn't it have only been able to go after one of us?
That's fair, yeah.
Entirely flavor, that's not how it actually works.
But it should.
It should, but... should and will are different. It is now Cassandra's turn with pitch on deck.
I'm going to try and squish it.
Okay.
Does a 9 hit?
No.
I'm a hero point.
That reminds me of if everybody was not at 3 at the beginning of this session, they should have taken an extra one.
I think everyone wants.
The dirty 20 hit.
Just barely.
It's squish.
Yeah, it's fine. You don't even really need to roll damage.
But you do need to cast Prestidigitation on your boot.
You can do that.
Can't. I can only do it once a day.
I don't think you've done it today.
Yeah, she has.
Oh.
Oh, wait, no, she hasn't.
Oh, that was yesterday.
That was yesterday. That was... If she did it again...
I'm thinking it's probably best to wait until the end of the fight to ungrowth my foot.
That's right.
What are you doing with your remaining 2 actions?
How do I... I'm going to wait for it to come to me, and then I'm going to hit it.
Okay.
Battle cleric. I like it.
Okay.
All right, so that's pitch.
Yep.
With Asidius on deck.
Yep. Pitch.
Thinking.
Okay.
Would like to take a free 5 foot okay, and now I am within 20 feet of this guy. I'm gonna throw my broom handle.
Roll to attack.
Piercing. Yeah. That's just what this sphere always does.
Mm-hmm. I'm being taken back then.
Okay.
15.
How much?
15, 1, 5.
Okay, that hits. Come on.
That's a 6. So plus my strength, 7.
Okay.
Okay. I have thrown my weapon. So my second action is going to be to take out my dagger. And I'm going to run over here.
Okay.
So that's 3. I'm done.
It is Obsidius with Fizzle on deck.
All right. Yep. Which one of these is damaged, if either?
The one to the right, which you cannot hit.
Over here?
The one I'm fighting is too far from me.
Yeah, that's more than 30 feet.
The pepper box is 30 foot, yeah.
I think it's like
25. Okay, yeah, so 40
feet away.
This guy in the spider web over here. I'm gonna shoot him. I'm gonna try to. That's. And. 7.
7 does not hit.
I figured. I'm gonna roll one more time. That is a.
Ooh, okay.
14.
That does. Did you do the minus 5?
Yes.
Okay. Dang, that was a good roll.
Thank you. That hit, so roll damage?
Yeah.
Is a 5.
4 damage, including the dex bonus.
Okay, and then I'm going to... Yeah, that's total.
Oh, you rolled awful here.
Yeah. Okay, so then I can only go, 30 feet?
Yep, you're a Durban. Durban's a bad.
So then, I'm gonna move over... Wait, hang on. I need to...
Ramp. I was wrong, you could have hit the guy.
Oh, well then I moved here anyways.
That's fine.
For future reference, your range on your pepper box is 60 feet.
Yeah, the range on the revolver was 30.
Yeah, well, now I'm in distance of both of them, so.
Nice.
Okay. It is now Fizzle's turn with the monsters on deck.
If any of them are left alive.
Yeah, you needed to change them.
All right, so. First things first, I'm the best. And we are going to. We're going to Ray of Frost. It's a ranged touch attack. And we're going to hit the one by Miss Pitch. Or we're going to attack the one by Miss Pitch. 16 hit.
Yeah,
well. It's a six.
A what hit?
16.
Yeah. 30 feet. Okay, that's fair.
2 damage.
Okay.
We're going to do that again. Does a 10 hit their touch AC?
10 does hit.
It's 2 more damage.
That's...
And for the final...
Wait.
Yes.
Did that 10 subtract your thing? The 10 that you rolled before, subtract the 5 from attacking the second entity?
Not for a spell, it doesn't.
It does.
No, it doesn't. Then don't take the 2, then. Miss. It's whatevs.
Yeah. Spells do incur the penalty. At least that's how I've been playing the spells.
We'll look it up later, just to clarify, but for now...
If they don't, that's overpowered and shouldn't be that way.
We'll double check it later.
I'm done.
Okay. It is the monster's turn. And the monsters are going to go here. That one is going to go there. And it's going to attack with a different die because it comes out of the hate scene. And that is a 17. Does that hit?
Who are you attacking?
Cassandra. Does it? Okay. That is 1 damage. And make a reflex save. What is that?
18. 1-8.
Nope, that doesn't... That worked. And I'm going to attack again. Natural 20. That's a crit. Gonna roll double damage.
Child.
Yes?
Child. I need you to speak directionally toward the mic and make sure you're projecting a little bit, okay?
Okay. That was a natural 20, and I just rolled 6 damage.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, what was that?
What? Said yuck, dislike, icky.
And you need to roll that reflex save again.
So 16 or 18? 15.
Oh, well, that makes the save.
18, 1-8.
Oh, 1-18. That definitely makes the save.
And also, remember, didn't you get an attack of opportunity? Not attack. Didn't you hold an action?
Yeah, that held action would just disappear on the next turn, though. if you don't use the held action before your next turn, you still only get the third.
That was before the next turn. Yeah, it should. This is the turn.
Oh, this is the monster's turn, so you do have a held action.
Yeah.
But smack it.
Yeah. What?
But not smack it.
Oh.
Wow.
Okay.
That was 5 on the pip.
Oh. Last roll. Does a 7 hit? No, it doesn't. The other monster is going to attack the person that's directly in front of them.
Figured that was coming.
And that is a 14. Does it hit?
No.
Okay.
Yes.
Yep. Next attack. That's a -1.
Nice.
Sorry. Yeah, -1. That doesn't hit. We're at a -3 now.
That's a -8.
Like all of
them. Oh, sorry, not -8. So I'm using a different die.
I think it's safe to say that pitch is just too fast to get hit.
Not a week.
Maybe they don't see because she's very dark in the dark shadows.
Okay, well, it is now Cassandra's turn with pitch on deck.
I'm gonna try and smack it again.
Fair enough.
Does an 18 hit?
Yes.
Great, 19. Yeah.
Yes. How much damage? How much? Okay. What is your next hit?
I'm gonna try and hit it again.
Okay.
And that's an 31 after the a 2 after the negative for the multi action.
So that doesn't hit.
Okay. And I'm going to just 5-foot step it away. Does that count as an action?
No. So 5-foot step.
Or in Cassandra's case, she actually jumps backwards 5 feet.
Right.
And then channel energy.
Gotta look up what channel energy does again.
Pop channels pop. I think for you would channel positive energy.
Yeah. But for the moment, no.
Okay. It's a healing thing.
I'm just gonna move.
Alright.
It is pitch with Obsidius on deck.
I have lost my beloved broomstick.
You can pick it up. It's like right in front of you.
Can I pick it up?
Yeah. I mean, the spiders can't grab it, so, you know.
But I already had my dagger out. I used an action to pull my dagger out.
Yeah.
Let me think about this. Because I'm betting that Pitch cannot dual wield. So.
And also, you can't wield the spear and the dagger at the same time. Anyway,
because it's a two, because the spear is a two-handed weapon.
Okay, so I've already got the dagger out, so I'm just going to go with it. I see my broomstick. I'm good with that. I'm just going to try to hit him with the dagger.
Okay.
I'm being distracted.
By what?
Fizzle.
That is a 14. Does that
hit? That hits.
God. Does 3 damage.
Okay.
I'm going to try to hit him again.
Is it piercing or... Okay, it doesn't matter for this.
It's a dagger, so I'm going to say it's stabbing damage. Yeah, piercing.
That's correct.
So it was either that or slashing. Which is why it didn't matter.
Is an 18 on the dice, so that's a 13. Does that hit? Hits? Excellent. That is another 3.
It is dead. That's the home button.
I'm gonna pick up my broomstick.
For your last action. Okay, it is Osidius's turn.
Okay.
With Fizzle on deck.
Gonna shoot the spider.
Shoot.
Nah, I'm gonna hero coin that one.
What was it on the dummy?
4.
Yeah, that's fair.
Another hero coin hits the table.
Are you...
Not one.
No, I've got the same thing.
That sucks. The 7. Dice that decided that you don't deserve life. And that misses.
Where's the dunce chair?
I'll get the dunce chair for you.
I need the dunce chair more than anything.
No, you don't. You're the DM.
Yes, I do. My dice have not been hitting. Like, at all.
Okay. So, first shot misses.
Give me the die. Give me the offending die.
Okay, so my first shot misses. I'm going to shoot it again. Much better.
That one.
No, 19 on the die.
Okay, so that would be...
let me see.
18.
22.
Okay, that hits.
Oh, what's my dex? Do I have dex bonus to damage or attack?
Both.
Oh, so then that's, let me just... So... 22 plus 4...
26.
Now we're gonna roll damage.
Which is 1d4 plus 4.
I... 7 in total.
Yeah, this monster is dead.
Woo!
And with that, I think our session is coming to an end.
We kill all the baddies?
Yeah, all of them. All of them are dead. That is all of the swarms of spiders.
Da 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 da.
Da 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 da.
You know, if somebody had followed the stream right then, it would have played that. That would have been great.
We have that, wait, no, we're using Zoom, not Discord. If we use Discord, I could have just played that sound.
Yeah. That's for...
That's why we should switch to Discord. Because we have a soundboard there.
Okay. Well, it was a pleasure. Fizzle out.
So, session's over. Stream's gonna be over too.
Alright, and we'll pick up again next week with you guys in the forest and fresh from your first real battle, which you guys did pretty well. Good job. So, I guess that's it. You can follow us on Twitter and Twitch, and this video will go up on YouTube in a day or two. You can subscribe, you can follow, you can follow us on Twitter.
You can follow us on Tumblr.
And Tumblr, yeah.
I might post something eventually. Probably not. Right.
So yeah, that's it for this week. We'll probably play something on Wednesday. It will not be Guilty Gear Strive.
Boo! It's my last week here. Come on.
It might be Guilty Gear Strive.
We might. We'll it might be. Might be Patrick playing Guilty Gear Strive.
Did you just hold up a peace sign and yell guitar at me?
Okay. I hate him.
Can we get a ooh woo?
Oh God, no!
No. No?
Thank you.
No woos for us. Okay. So we'll see you guys on Wednesday, or if you don't want to hang out for video game stuff, we'll see you next Sunday. Abby will still be DMing, and we're going to continue this little mini campaign. Are you DMing from afar? So next time we'll be at the table with me, so there will be lots of text messages flying back and forth. So, all right, guys. Have a good night. Bye.
Bye.